with the same money, no matter.
The room I used to sleep in was where my dad used to paint, and all on the walls were sort of pictures that he'd taken out of art books that he'd nicked from the library, and he'd stick them all up on the wall. So when, every time I go to sleep or woke up, I was surrounded by art, be it Utrillo, Constable, Flamenco, you know. So I was sort of surrounded by it. And also, I sort of, as I got older, I realised that there were a lot of artists called Paul. So that in some ways it sort of seemed to reiterate the fact that that's obviously got to be my job when I grow up.
Get up!
Yeah, skank it, step it, rub it, scrub it, jump it.
And that's one of my favourite pictures, that's the Shrimp Girl, and that's by Hogarth. And this painting was apparently, after he died, was found in his studio, propped up against the wall. But what I really like about this picture is the freshness and the colour, and it's just very spontaneous and alive. It's a nice Bradley picture of a toilet. I think subjects like that, I don't know, I find them really exciting. I mean, they're sort of mundane, everyday things, but I think it's how they're made, sort of, in the ordinary, extraordinary. I sort of quite like the thing of that.
Watch your steps.
One thing that was quite interesting, when I was doing these paintings, I did a whole series of paintings of like bacon and eggs in the frying pan and sort of mugs of tea. And it was interesting, somebody said, Del, that Paul, that's just your paintings, it's just you trying to reassert your working classness. And I thought, I never really thought of it like that, but maybe it is. I don't know, I guess I just paint and what comes out comes out, or what my interests are, you know, in terms of visual stuff. You know, I like a lot of the kitchen sink stuff, the ash can school, Saturday night, Sunday morning films, you know, the It's Grim Up North type films. After 7 years of non-stop touring, travelling together, I mean, we didn't stop for holidays or anything like that, and I think after a while we just sort of, I don't know, it's. I mean, I don't want to put Mick on the spot, I mean, it's, but it's his fault. Now, I mean, you know, I guess, I don't know what to say. I mean, Mick was like Elizabeth Taylor. That's Joe's quote about Mick. It was like going on tour with Elizabeth Taylor in a filthy mood. It was. And after a while, at some point, me and Joe just looked at each other and said, you know what, let's get rid of him. And we knew, even though we knew we were getting a really important member of the band, really, you know, Mick's contribution was he was sort of like the sort of Jagger, Richard, sort of Lennon and McCartney duo that was coming up with those amazing songs. So. But we just thought, you know what, we've had enough. So what? We're like 27 now. Just throw the hat and get rid of him.
with a thimble splash, a word of truth and a rocking bass and drum.
The advice I'd give to a young Paul Simon is just, what would I say? I don't know, just bloody behave, fucking brat. I don't know what I'd say to a young Paul Simon. Clip round the ear, old mate. So you just do what you want to do. You know, if you want to paint, paint. If you want to do music, which hopefully he'd listen. But then being me, I've always done what I've wanted to do on my own terms. You know, if I don't want to do that, I ain't going to do it. So it's like, I spent so much time not being at school that it's because I didn't like it. It's just like tedious. I thought it's got to be something more interesting than doing this. I mean, I did miss my mates at school, but then some of them would hop off school with me, so we had a bit of a laugh. Yeah, I think I've been really fortunate only because I found painting, and really what I'm saying is that I found an outlet with all the inner turmoil and angst that every human being has inside. If you can find something to channel it out, that's like whether it's writing a book or writing a poem, making a film, or in my case, making a painting, that's a fortunate thing.